नमस्ते, मैं सेल्फ जेवियन डॉक्टर खुशबू वर्मा, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट ऑस्मोसिस बाय यूजिंग पोटेटो ऑस्मोस्कोप। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑस्मोसिस। सो ऑस्मोसिस इज अ स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ डिफ्यूजन ऑफ लिक्विड्स व्हेन टू सॉल्यूशंस ऑफ डिफरेंट कंसेंट्रेशंस आर सेपरेटेड बाय अ सेलेक्टिवली परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन। डिफ्यूजन ऑफ वाटर और सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल्स टेक प्लेस फ्रॉम द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ लोअर कंसेंट्रेशन टू द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ हायर कंसेंट्रेशन। दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड ऑस्मोसिस। देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ द सॉल्यूशंस। फर्स्ट इज हाइपरटोनिक, हाइपोटोनिक एंड थर्ड वन इज आइसोटोनिक सॉल्यूशंस। इमेजिन अ सिस्टम इन विच एन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन ए विद हाई कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ सॉल्यूट इज सेपरेटेड बाय अ सेलेक्टिवली परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन फ्रॉम एन एक्वस सॉल्यूशन बी with a low concentration of solute. The solution A is said to be hypotonic to solution B and solution B is hypotonic to the solution A. In this situation, there will be a net movement of water or solvent molecules through the membrane from the hypotonic solution to the hypertonic solution by osmosis. This will continue until equilibrium is reached, at which point there is no further movement of water and the two solutions are described as isotonic. Now come to the demonstration of osmosis. The process of osmosis may be demonstrated by the simple osmometer, which is the Thistle-Fernel experiment. Next one is potato osmoscope. So demonstration of osmosis in a living system can be done by using the potato osmoscope. A potato is peeled and one side is flattened, which serves as the base. A cavity is made in the potato and is filled with the concentrated sugar solution, and a pink mark is made to initiate the initial level, indicate the initial level. This potato is then placed in a beaker containing colored water for some time. Now we will observe this experiment. So it is observed that the solution, sugar solution, in the cavity of the potato becomes colored and level rises. So this proves the entry of water into the sugar solution through the potato tissues, which serves as the selective permeable membrane. Along with that, we will discuss about the plasmolysis. When a plant cell is placed in hypertonic solution, the process of exosmosis starts and water from the cell sap diffuses out into the solution of external medium. This causes a reduction in the tension of the cell wall and brings about the contraction of protoplasm due to the continuous loss of water. The protoplasm becomes rounded in the shape due to contraction, and such a cell is said to be plasmolyzed, and the phenomenon is referred to as a plasmolysis. The initial stage of plasmolysis, where the protoplasm just starts leaving the cell wall, is called incipient plasmolysis. When a completely plasmolyzed cell is again placed in water or a hypotonic solution, endosmosis takes place and the protoplasm regains its original state and shape. That is, the cell becomes fully turgid. This phenomenon is reverse of the plasmolysis, so it is called as deplasmolysis. What is the significance of plasmolysis? It helps to understand the living nature of the cell, helps to prevent meat jellies and used in pickling, as their salting kills bacteria by plasmolysis. Used to prove the permeability of the cell wall and selectively permeable nature of the plasma membrane. Now we will discuss about some pressure. So first of all, we need to discuss about the osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure of a solution is the pressure which must be applied to it in order to prevent the passage of the solvent due to osmosis. In the other words, it is that pressure which is needed to check the process of osmosis. The term osmotic potential is also used in place of osmotic pressure. Next one is turgid pressure. When the plant cell is placed in water, it will swell but will not burst. Due to the negative osmotic potential of the cell sap, water moves into the cell and causes the plasma membrane to press against the cell wall. This pressure responsible for pressing the plasma membrane against the cell wall is called Turgot pressure. Turgot pressure may be also defined as the hydrostatic pressure developed inside the cell on the cell wall due to endosmosis. Next one is wall pressure. So as a result of Turgot pressure on the cell wall, the rigid cell wall exerts an equal pressure on the opposite direction called wall pressure. Next one is diffusion pressure defects, DPD, or suction pressure. This pressure exerted by a diffusing particle is called diffusion pressure. When solute is added, the diffusion pressure of a solution is lowered. The amount by which diffusion pressure of a solution is lower than that of its pure solvent is known as diffusion pressure defects, which was described as suction pressure by Renner in 1915. So this is the sum up of this session, and this session is called by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur, and this session is will be helpful. And if you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.